Hello everyone, Success Series is back with another video, and this time we are going to discuss Chapter 2, that is Forest and Wildlife Resources of CBSE NCERT Class 10th. Let's see how forest is a resource for us. Forests are broadly classified into flora, that is the plant species, and fauna, that are the animal species. You will be surprised to know our country has rich diversity of flora and fauna. There are over 45,000 plant species and 81,251 animal species. It represents about 7% of world flora and 6.5% of world fauna. Now let's see how plant is a resource for us. Plants gives us food, fodder, firewood, fiber, timber, medicine, gums, tannin. These are all materialistic things. Other than these, plants have aesthetic value, acts as windbreaks, provide shade, give frost protection, provide us with oxygen, firewood, stop erosion, and fix nitrogen. Animals are also resources. They provide us dairy products, meat, flesh, antlers, fur, tusks, medicines. Based on the International Union for Conservation of Nature and Natural Resources, that is IUCN, flora and fauna is basically classified into six categories. The first one is the normal species, the endangered species, extinct species, endemic species, rare species, and vulnerable species. So that you don't miss any name in the examination, here is a short trick. You can remember the initials of all the letters of this species with this shortcut, NE cube RV, where N represent normal species and E cube represents endangered, extinct, endemic, R represent rare species and V represent vulnerable species. Normal species are those whose population levels are normal and can be seen easily. For example, the cattles, sol, pine, rodent, etc. Endangered species are those who are at the risk of being extinction. That means they can extinct from a particular area, a state, a country, or even planet. The example of these are like dinosaurs. Dinosaurs are extinct from our planet now. Some more examples are the black buck, Indian rhino. The next is the extinct species. These species are which are not found after searches of known or likely areas where they may occur. We cannot do any effort to recover these species now. Some of the examples are Asiatic cheetah, pink head duck, and China bull. Endemic species is the one whose habitat is very restricted and they found in particular areas only. Endemic species can be of plant, fungus, or even microorganisms. Some examples are Nicobar pigeon, Andaman wild pig, and Mithun in Arunachal Pradesh. Rare species are the organisms which are very uncommon and they are always considered as endangered as they cannot recover the catastrophic events. The vulnerable species is the one which has been categorized by IUCN as likely to become endangered unless the circumstances threatening its survival and reproduction improve. The examples are blue sheep, gigantic dolphin, Asiatic elephants. Now let's see how we can conserve the forest and wildlife which is doing so much for us. The first initiative in this was the Wildlife Protection Act of 1972. The Wildlife Protection Act of 1972 basically consists of the laws and the protections which are given to the plants and animal species and the punishment which to be given to the person who harmed the wildlife. It extends to the whole of the India except the state of Jammu and Kashmir, which has its own Wildlife Act. This act is divided into six schedules. The Schedule 1 and Schedule 2 has absolute protection offenses and under these are the prescribed highest penalties. The species which are listed in Schedule 3 and Schedule 4 are also protected but penalties are very much lower here. The Schedule 5 includes the animals which may be hunted, and the plants in the Schedule 6 are prohibited from cultivation and planting. The amendments are given in these acts are, first amendment was in 1980, Several hundred butterflies and moths, beetles, and one dragonfly has been added to the list. Amendment in 1991 also took place. In this, plants were also added in the list of these species. The next initiative was the Project Tiger. This project started in the tenure of Indira Gandhi, and this project focuses on conserving the Bengal tiger in India. There are different types and distribution given to the forest and wildlife resources. Let's have a look at them. Reserve forests are those which are judicially and constitutionally protected, and this more than half of the area of forest is reserved. The example of these forests are Hanuman Sagar Reserve Forest, Kerala, and Bego Reserve Forest, Kerala. Protected forests also have some amount of legal and constitutional protection, and one third of the total forest is preserved. The last one on the unclassed forest, they do not have any specific protection. They are all kind of government and private or individually or community owned forests. Let's see how community plays its role in conservation of wildlife. Local people can be taken help to manage the local resources and inspire people globally. The community conservation catalyzes, facilitates, and empowers local people to manage and conserve natural resources within the social, cultural, and economic context of their communities. Some example of community conservation is the Chipko movement. In the 1970s, this movement started when the destruction of forest was like widespread. People of village used to hug the trees to prevent them from getting cut by the contractors. The second is the sacred groves. Sacred groves of India are forest fragments of varying sizes which are commonly protected due to some significant religious beliefs, and hunting and logging are usually strictly prohibited in these patches. That's all for this chapter. Do hit the like button if you like this video.